Heavenly Father, who art in heaven, Lord, please bless everyone who is here and everyone who might be on their way. Lord, just like help anyone that is here that, you know, needs to make that decision. Lord, help them, you know, hold their hand and guide them. In your Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
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 Okay, so in the Bible, book of John chapter 3, it tells the story of a Pharisee, Nicodemus, as you're doing the text. Nicodemus, he was a part of the Jewish council, you know, he had a high position. So he went to see God and Jesus at night because he didn't want anyone to see him going to Jesus. And Nicodemus, he goes to Jesus and he's like, you know, I know you are a teacher sent from God because you can do all these miracles. And, you know, how can you do this? And Jesus says to him, like, if, you know, you cannot enter into heaven unless you are born again. And Jesus is like, well, I'm so old. How can I be, you know, reborn? Like, can I go back into my mother's womb and come back out? And Jesus says, I tell you the truth. No one can enter the kingdom of God unless he is born of water and the Spirit. Now, what does it mean, born of water? Yes, it does. Being born of water means to be baptized. Baptism is mentioned 80 times in the New Testament. And in this picture, we can see, you know, the different forms of baptism. You know, we see the baby being sprinkled over here. And over here, we have another picture of the baby, you know, completely inside of the water. But is it true that it doesn't matter how we're baptized, you know, why we're baptized, just so as long as we're baptized? Is that true?
No.
No, it's not true. As it says in the Bible, Ephesians 4:5, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. Hey. And that doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, you can only be one baptized once. It just means that there's only one true form of baptism, and that's, you know, totally being submerged into the water.
Hey.
And so right here, Jesus is telling his disciples, you know, go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you, always even to the end of age. Amen. So he's saying, go, you know, share my teachings with them, baptize them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and, you know, tell them to do what I command and what I have done.
Amen.
It says in the Bible, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. So belief and baptism goes hand in hand. You can't, you know, be baptized and not believe, because that's not going to help you go anywhere.
Amen.
Just like how you, you know, you might believe in God and not be baptized, but that's not going to help you to get to heaven. So here's a picture of John the Baptist. You know, he went out and he shared God's word and he baptized people. Then Jerusalem, all Judea, and all the region around the Jordan went out to him and were baptized by him in the Jordan, confessing their sins. So before they were baptized, they confessed their sins to John, and, you know, John baptized them.
It's
like we see the Jordan River, and, you know, the river, it doesn't have any special power. It's what the river symbolizes, you know, being born again, your rebirth. So you can be, you know, baptized in the pool, at the beach, you know, wherever. It's just like what that body of water symbolizes.
Amen.
So Jesus, he goes to John to be baptized, and, you know, John's like, you know, I should have been See, here is water. What hinders me from being baptized? Then Philip said, if you believe with all your heart, you may. So he commanded the chariot to stop. Chariot, stop. And both Philip and Eunice went down into the water, and he baptized them. So you see, it says that they both went down into the water. Like, Philip didn't go and say, you know, wait here. Let me just go get some water, and came back and sprinkled Eunice. No, they both went down into the water, and Eunice was totally submerged underneath the water.
Amen.
In the Bible, it tells us that baptism symbolizes the death of Jesus, the burial, and the resurrection.
Amen.
Don't you know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? So our baptism symbolizes the death of our old self and our old ways. We were there buried with him through baptism into death in that order. That just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we may too live a new life. So when you bury your old self, you know, going down into the water, and then you come up, that's your new life. You know, it's a new page. You're no longer the old you. You've buried your sins.
Amen.
So death to our old sinful way of life, you know. Whatever you were doing in the past, you know, vow to no longer do. I'm not gonna curse, I'm not gonna lie, I'm not gonna steal, I'm not gonna fornicate, you know. Everything that's sinful and that is not of God, you leave it in the past.
Amen.
Burial of our sins in the Lord we gave, you know, so all of our sins, cursing, you know, our bad habits, anything that is not of Christ, we leave that in our watery grave. In resurrection to a new life in Christ, we're new us. So, you know, I'm no longer the old Candace. You know, when I got baptized, I became a new person.
Amen.
And I started, you know, writing a new story about my life.
Praise the Lord.
So it was not until the Council of Ravenna in AD 1311 that sprinkling and pouring were officially accepted as equally valid as immersion in the rite of baptism. But not because, you know, the Council of Ravenna said that sprinkling was equal to baptism. That doesn't mean that that changes what God wants for us and changes what God, you know, accepts. It's still the same. God wants total immersion into water, and he wants us to believe.
Amen.
Do you believe that babies should be baptized?
No,
they shouldn't. You know, they're babies. They have no sin to wash away, and they're not mature enough to make that decision. Like, we're making that decision for them, and we should wait until an individual is old enough to say, okay, you know what, I know that I've sinned, and I don't want to live this life anymore. So
Amen.
I'm going to repent my sins, and I'm going to go to Christ.
Amen. Yes, indeed.
Amen.
So what does baptism mean? The Greek word baptizo means to dip, to immerse, to plunge underwater. Acts 2:37. Men and brethren, what shall we do? What shall we do? Step one, repent. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. You know, so when you repent your sins, you know, when you go to be baptized, you know, you receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, and, you know, that helps you to go through your life, because it's going to be hard, trust me. There's a lot of temptation.
Amen.
Step two, we have to believe in, you know, we have to believe that, you know, Jesus, in Jesus' second coming, we have to believe in Jesus, the commandments. Baptism and belief goes hand in hand. Then Philip said, if you believe with all your heart, you may. We have to learn, you know, we have to continue learning about Jesus. Like, once you're baptized, it doesn't stop there. You have to continue reading, continue having your devotions, you know, Bible studies. We have to keep, you know, learning and building knowledge about believe, and accept Jesus as both Savior and Lord. Learn instruction in the essentials of biblical faith. That does baptism mean that I am becoming a part of Christ's church?
Yes.
Yes, it does. As it says in the Bible, and the Lord added to the church daily those who were being saved. You know, we become a part of Christ. For by one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. You know, like, and He is the head of the body, the church. You know, Jesus is the vine and we are the branches. Like, a plant can't, you know, survive without that, you know, being attached to that, the main stem of the tree. You know, it will fall off and it will wither. Just like how we won't survive if we don't have, you know, Jesus, we're not connected to Him.
Amen. Amen.
Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you, and know I am with you always, even to the end of the age. So Jesus is saying, you know, I create an example for you. So I want you to tell them what I've done so they can, you know, do the same as me. Jesus was baptized. Should we get baptized?
Yes.
Jesus